I'm sure about this. And anyway, it's a good school. Santa Lucia University offers quality education and has adequate facilities. It's okay.
I might study there too.
Then that's good. We can be together every day. Hey, why the long face?
I'm sorry, Carding. But I am happy. It's just that times like this, I wish I could still share this happy feeling with my family.
We can tell them the truth if you like. We're not doing anything wrong anyway. And maybe if I talk to your mother, you know, tell her about my intentions, then she'll realize I wouldn't do anything to hurt their daughter.
It's not the way she thinks. I know she wouldn't approve. I love you, Carding. But I also love my family. I can't turn my back on them. I can't leave my family.
Don't worry, Luisa. Nothing is permanent in this world. Someday, your mother and my mother will accept our relationship and the love we have for each other. I believe it is possible, and it can happen soon. Nothing can stand between us. Our love will be forever. I promise. Our love will prevail.
Hi, Jago.
Didn't I tell you earlier to leave the varnishing to me?
It's okay. I don't mind doing it.
Oh, I almost forgot. Wait here, Totoy. I'll return the hammer I borrowed from your father. I'll just get it inside.
It's a bit hot out here. Hey, you're good. You did it evenly. Who taught you how to apply varnish?
Totoy, I can't find your hammer yet. Would you like to wait here inside?
You've got beautiful hair, Jojo.
So how did it go, Banjo?
It's all set, sir.
Good. Very good. I know I can always depend on you.
I told you, boss. You can always count on me. Banjo always delivers.
Great, Banjo. Very good. Oh, hi, Mena.
Go ahead, David.
Wait, I have good news.
Really?
Yes, I'm quite sure you'll like what's next on our agenda. You will have to entertain all the rich landowners in this town.
Wine and dine. I like that. A social gathering. I'll do the preparations myself to make sure everything is perfect.
Why not throw a party at your house so your sponsors can get to know you better and your potential benefactors?
So we now have sponsors?
We have a few. By the way, Manang, I will need another 500,000.
I thought we already have sponsors. What about the 1 million that was donated to our campaign fund?
But I used that money to pay off Carding's hospital bills, remember? That's more than 600,000, while the rest of the money I used to build and manage your campaign headquarters. Manang, I need more money to make sure that your campaign runs smoothly.
Okay, fine. I'll give you the money tomorrow, David. But don't get used to it, because after tomorrow, I won't shell out any more of my money lest I go broke. It should be my turn to receive money.
Don't worry, Manang. Banjo.
Yes, sir?
Call your former boss. I need to speak with him.
Hello, Tekla. I'm on my way home.
What? But madam, I'm on my way to your campaign headquarters. I thought you might need an assistant, so I'd like to volunteer.
I'd rather you do volunteer work in my house and cook, okay? I want a nice meal when I get home.
Hi, Mother. I see you're all here.
Hi, Cardine. You came right on time. Come and join us.
Hello, Cardine.
We are celebrating because according to the latest survey, I got the highest rating among all the candidates. You are looking at the future mayor.
Wow, Mother. Great news.
Come.
I'm so proud of you.
By the way, Carmen, this Saturday, I'm hosting a party for my supporters. So, I'm counting on you to be there.
No problem. What do you need?
Well, it's going to be a big party. I was thinking of hiring additional staff.
All right. I'll ask my people to help you.
Good.
I'll ask Louisa to come too. That child is so diligent. She's a good child. You raised her well, Eddard.
What do you say, Eddard? You think Louisa can come and help us out?
I'll ask her, madam.
Okay, that's good.
It must be tough, campaigning for a public office, Manang. But since Carding is here, he'll be able to help you.
I know Carding can help me. But by then, he'll be in the city studying.
Oh, the city. So you didn't know Manang? Oh, I'm sorry, Carding. Haven't you told your mother yet?
Told me what?
Let's just talk about it later, Mother.
No. Let's talk about it now. What is it, Carding? You don't want to tell me? Fine. All right, Mimi. Tell me about it. What's going on?
Well, Carding said that he wasn't going to study in the city anymore. He wants to finish his college degree in this town.
What? Study in that inferior Santa Lucia University? What is wrong with you? Have you lost your marbles when you had an accident? This is crazy. What were you thinking?
Mother, I want to stay here for your campaign. There are too many crazy people out there. I know you have bodyguards to protect you, but I will feel more secure if I stay here. That way I can watch over you. Right? I mean, that's a valid point.
You want to watch over me? I'll be fine, don't worry. David is here, and he'll make sure I'm well protected. It's more important for me that you attend a prestigious school. Therefore, you will study in the city. No arguments. Eat.
I said I'm sorry, okay? I had to tell the truth. I really am sorry. Don't be mad at me now, Carding. Please, let's be friends again. What?
Are you really my friend, Mimi?
Of course I am.
I'm not sure. It doesn't feel like you're being a friend. It feels more like you're misleading me to get what you want. To persuade and manipulate me.
Now why would you say that?
I was just quoting you, Mimi.
That's a lie. Who told you that? I bet it's Louisa, right?
It doesn't matter who told me. Did you say those words?
Of course not. I wouldn't do that. Is that how you perceive me? Carding, Louisa may have overheard Chelsea and me talking, but she got it all wrong. You know how Chelsea can be sometimes. She told me that I should play you around instead of helping you and Louisa. But I said to her, I couldn't manipulate you and Louisa. I said I could not do that. I said I have no right to ask you to do what I want. Carding, I know you. You are firm in your resolve. You wouldn't let anyone influence or manipulate you once you've made your decision. Why did you think I would do such a mean thing? I am not your enemy. I told you I am with you and Louisa. If I really wanted to break you two apart, I would have told your mother about your friendship with Louisa. I always go out with your mother, but I never told her anything. I never did, Cardine. Because you were my friend.
You're right, I'm sorry. I never should have doubted you. I'm so sorry, okay? Stop crying. I believe you.
Quickly, hurry up! The guests will be coming here shortly. Hey, you! Where are the waiters?
They're waiting outside, miss.
Good. Louisa, put those glasses over there. Hurry! Move quickly, please.
Louisa, are you okay? I know you don't want to see Cardine, but I can't say no to Miss Carmen. I'm so sorry, dear.
I'm okay, Mother.
Just steer clear of him. Call me if ever bothers you again.
Yes, I need to get napkins for the tables.
Okay, go ahead.
Hi.
Don't do that, Cardine. Mother might see us.
But I miss you.
Cardine, this is not the right time. I have to go back to work, so please, don't do anything silly, or we might get into trouble with our parents, okay?
Okay. I won't disturb you the whole day. Is that enough? By the way, I've ironed out things with Mimi.
What? I told you not to talk to her. It would only make matters worse.
It won't. I'm sure of it. It was a misunderstanding. Okay? I see Mother's looking for me. I have to go.
Cardine, please, I want you to promise me you won't tell Mimi anything about our relationship.
Louisa.
Please?
Okay, promise.
Cross your heart.
Okay, promise. Goodbye.
Welcome, Governor, Congressman. Thank you so much for coming. Come in, this way. Manang.
Oh, yes.
Manang.
Okay.
Oh, please excuse me. What is it, David?
Congressman Flores.
Hi.
Hello.
Governor Pizarras.
Hello, I'm
allow me to introduce
to you
Manang Medel and her son, Carding.
Nice
these two
to meet
gentlemen
you.
Are among your supporters,
hi,
Manang.
Sir.
I'm so grateful for your support. And for coming here.
Hi, I'm Mimi Sandoval. Hi, Governor. Nice to meet,
to meet you.
Hi, Congressman. Nice to meet you.
Your fiancé?
Oh, no, she's just a friend.
Sandoval, you're Carmen's daughter, right? You were valedictorian in your class. I was invited to speak at your graduation.
Well, if I were in your shoes, young man, I would grab the lady beside you. Not only is she smart and beautiful, but she also comes from a prominent family. She is so right for you, son. She can also help you with your campaign, Menem.
I agree, but I don't know what's holding him back. I told my son to pursue Mimi. No one is worthy to be my daughter-in-law except her.
Your mother is right, Kading. She will be a strong asset.
Manang, you can be sure of their support during this election period.
I'm so grateful.
Right, Governor and Congressman?
Thank you so much. I'm so delighted that you could grace our party with your presence.
I wonder where Jojo is. I'm hungry.
Is she still coming?
Diego. Your sister's here.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
Jojo, what are you wearing? Why do you have a giant butterfly on your hair? What's for lunch? Let's see. Here. Jojo, sit here.
Yeah, right.
What?
I'm never cooking for you again.
Why? What's wrong? She looks good.
What? The giant butterfly looks good on her.
Louisa, wait. We need to talk.
Sir, would you care for a drink?
Huh? No, I don't. Luisa, wait.
Hey, Luisa.
Yes?
We're running out of glasses. Go to the kitchen and get more glasses.
Hurry. Yes, madam.
Strong, believable. Leadership.
Luisa, come here.
What? Where are you taking me? Mother might see us.
Come here. This way.
Don't you have anything better to do than to drag me all over the house?
I had to because you refused to talk to me.
What for? This relationship is going nowhere.
Why are you crying?
I feel so embarrassed, Cardine. Now I realize how insignificant and useless I am in your world.
What are you talking about, Luisa? When two people are in love, it doesn't matter whether they're rich or they're poor.
Please, let's not kid ourselves. Tell me, how will your mother introduce me? Friends, this is Luisa, the daughter of our laundry woman. An arrogant lowlife who thinks she belongs in my wonderful family.
She won't say those words. Instead, she'll say, "This is Luisa, the woman my son loves so much. The woman who makes my son very happy." And if she will permit it, my son would like to marry her.
Kurtding, this is not a joke. I'm serious, okay?
I am serious, Luisa. I want to marry you.
Oh, goodness. I really have to go.
Okay, come on, let's go find another bathroom.
Hey, Carmen.
Mm.
I've been looking all over for you.
I've been waiting for my turn, but someone is still inside.
Listen to me. People can always say and think what they want about us, but I don't care, because they don't matter to me. They are not important. What matters is we love each other. It's the most important thing for me.
Are you sure about that? What if one day you realize we are not meant for each other? When that happens, I know you'll leave me.
It will never happen. I will never leave you. You are far more important to me than all the riches you see around us. Luisa, I love you. I love you so much, Luisa. I love you so much.
I apologize for the inconvenience. Someone must have locked it by accident. You may use the one in my room.
Okay.
Ah, Tekla.
Mm-hmm. Yes, madam?
Could you show Carmen to my room, please?
Yes, madam. This
okay,
way, madam
thank
Carmen.
You.
I'm sorry. Eddad, could you get the bathroom key inside my closet?
Yes, madam.
Are you okay now?
Yes.
Anybody in there? Is there someone inside? Please open the door.
Darn.
What seems to be the problem?
The door's locked.
Here, Madame Menem.
Garding? What are you doing here?
I was trying to fix the toilet, Mother.
Then why didn't you answer me? I've been knocking several times.
Oh, but I did. Maybe you just didn't hear me because of all the noise outside. But I did say I was here.
Go back to the party, Mimi.
Mm-hmm.
Leave that for the plumber, Cardenio.
No, this won't take long. I can fix this. Better go back to your party while your guests are waiting for you. I'm fine.
Gardein, don't you want me to run for public office?
Mother, I'm fine with it. I have no problem with it.
Are you quite certain?
I'm sure.
It's good you agree. The people like me so much, you know. In fact, the congressman and the governor are so happy I'm running for mayor.
Oh, so what are you still doing here? You go out there and mingle with your guests, Mother. Okay, I'll take care
Fine,
of this.
But don't be long, okay?
Okay.
Leave that work for the plumber, Cardin. Ask Tekla to call Poldi.
Okay, yes, Mother.
Okay? I never noticed it, but this washroom looks so old.
What? I guess.
It's a good thing I asked guests to use the washroom upstairs. Maybe I should have this room renovated. Is the shower still working?
Oh, Mother, it's not right for a party to go on without a host, right? Come on, your guests are waiting.
All right. Don't be long.
Yes.
Hey, Jojo, your brother's looking for you. Wait, what happened to your ribbon?
Please, I'm not in the mood for insults, okay?
But I just said...
Come on, say it. I act like a boy. You're right. I do not act like a girl.
You may act like a boy, but for me, you're a girl.
Then why did you tell your family I act like a boy, huh?
What? I don't understand. I never said anything like that.
I heard it from your brother, Pippin.
Well, I don't know where Pippin got the idea, but I didn't tell him anything. Promise. I swear.
Is that the truth?
Yes, of course.
It wasn't you?
Yes. Friends again?
Excuse me.
Luisa.
Yes, I know.
Where have you been? I haven't seen you for almost an hour.
I was, tied up in the living room, and, I was also in the garden, and, I was going around serving people their drinks.
How is everybody? Are you all having fun? Thank you so much for your support. Let's eat. I've prepared a feast for all of us. Tonight, we'll dine and have fun.
What if I try out for the varsity basketball team? Do you think, you know, I stand a chance?
We don't have a women's basketball team in our school.
Really? Oh, I'll start a women's team then. But if that does not work, I'll join the men's team.
Well, you're better than most of the players in our men's team. You dribble the ball like a pro.
Hey, check this out.
Hey, I didn't know you were still here.
Yes, I was just talking to Totai, but don't worry, I'm on my way home.
So I suppose you two have made up. You friends again? Well, I hate to break this up, but lunch is over. Back to work.
Uh-huh. Thank you for the food.
Here
you
nothing. Go. See you.
Goodbye, Jojo.
Bye. Bye, Toy.
Drink, madam? I saw you leave the washroom earlier. What? You don't have to deny it. I know you were in the washroom with Cardine, right? It wasn't me. Louisa. You have nothing to worry about. Your secret's safe with me. Come on, you can tell me. I'm happy for you and Cardine. Were you just talking inside the washroom? I believe you wouldn't do anything against your principal. Not you. Not the pure and chaste Louisa. I don't know what you're talking about. Just tell me the truth. Is Cardine your boyfriend? No, Mimi.
Louisa.
What is wrong with you? Stop trying to look for me. We almost got caught earlier.
Almost, but not quite.
Not quite? Mimi said she saw me coming out of the washroom. I denied everything, of course, but I don't think she ever believed me.
It doesn't matter. It's just Mimi.
Cardine, please. While I'm still here working at your mother's party, do not speak with me, okay?
Louisa.
I'm serious. Do not talk to me.
Fine, but I don't know if I can stay away from you.
I'm not kidding, Cardine. Please stay away from me. Do you understand?
Cardine! Louisa, Tekla needs you outside. I heard my daughter clearly say to you to stay away from her. How many times must she tell you that before you begin to understand? You're being disrespectful to her.
I didn't mean to be rude.
I'm not interested to hear your explanation. My daughter wants you to leave her alone.
Madame and Dad, I was just talking to Louisa.
Please spare my daughter, Cardine. She refuses to fight back because you're my employer's son, so she tolerates your rudeness. But I won't, because I'm not my daughter. Even if it means losing my job, even if we go hungry, I will fight for my daughter's rights. I'm ready to kill and be killed for her. Louisa, what? Are you okay? Did Cardine hurt you?
Cardine wouldn't hurt me, Mother. Forgive me, Mother, for...
It's not your fault, dear. This wouldn't have happened if I didn't bring you here to help us. This is all my fault.
I need to tell you something very important, Mother. It's not easy for me, but...
I know what you're going through, but I've spoken with Cardine. I told him loud and clear I don't want him anywhere near you. Even if he says his intentions are pure, I won't allow him to court you.
Did Cardine say anything to you?
He doesn't have to say it. I know what he wants. He may be your friend, Louisa, but do not be swayed by his words. He's just playing games with you. He will hurt you and leave you. Cardine is not right for you. He'll put an end to our dreams. Don't let him destroy us.
Being late, I think. But I think
you have thank you so much, Governor.
Thank you, and thank you for coming.
Well, it looks like a sure thing, so I'll see you at the mayor's office.
Thank you.
Don't forget our deal.
Don't worry about it. Thanks again, and good night.
I'll show you.
Okay, Carmen. Thank you.
Yes, I enjoyed the party. Did you?
Manon, come see how many people contributed to your campaign. Look at this. I'm probably holding 9 million.
Did you say 9 million? In just one night? Give me that. I'll deposit it in my...
Wait a minute. I should keep this.
I'm starting to notice something, David. Every time campaign money comes in, it goes straight to you.
But of course. I'm your campaign manager. I manage the finances for your campaign. Do you think I'll keep the money and deceive you?
Well, wouldn't you?
Manang, this money is not enough to get you a seat in public office. If you spend this money for personal use now, we can't be sure of your victory. I'm certain you wouldn't want to lose, right? You wouldn't want to lose all your property. Do you want that to happen?
All right, you win. I'll let you be in charge.
Take care of the finances and supervise my whole campaign. But I'm warning you, David. Don't think you can mess around with me. You wouldn't like me when I'm angry. If I find out you've deceived me, I have no qualms about killing you. You're leaving? Thank you all for coming.
Thank you.
I hope you had a marvelous
Congratulations,
time.
Benna.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thanks for your support.
Okay, bye-bye.
We'll see you.
Good night.
I need an answer,
Cardine. Goodbye.
See you.
Good night.
What really happened?
I was alone inside the washroom. Why do you insist otherwise?
Then why did I see her come out of the room?
How should I know? Maybe she went in as I got out. Or maybe it's not her.
I'm not stupid, Cardine. I know I saw Louisa, okay? Why don't you admit it? Fine, just tell me the truth. Is Louisa your girlfriend?
No.
Then what were you doing in the bathroom?
I've had enough. This conversation is getting nowhere. I was alone in the washroom, period.
Well, looks like the party was a success. I'm
yes,
quite
it was.
Certain I got the support of almost all the landowners and officials in town.
I'm sure. Congratulations, Mother. Mwah.
Thanks, son, for helping me out.
Anytime.
It's off to bed for me.
Okay,
good night,
Mother.
Love.
Madam Manon? May I speak with you?
What is it? Make it quick.
This won't take long. I know it's short notice, but I want to resign from my job.
Why? Are you leaving me to serve in another household?
No, madam.
Did I do anything to hurt your feelings?
No, madam.
Then what's wrong? Why are you leaving?
I'm leaving for personal reasons.
Well, Edad, it's hard to make a living these days. I don't want you to regret your decision. So I will not accept your resignation yet. I want you to think about it. We'll talk about this again tomorrow.
You want to resign from your work? Why? I thought you were worried Manon might let go of some of her household help.
It was different then. I didn't realize how relentless Cardine was annoying our daughter, Louisa.
You don't have to resign from work, Mother.
I need to do this, dear. I know you did everything to avoid Cardine. You even put up with his advances. I should do my part, too, to stop Cardine from bothering you.
Don't worry, Mother. I'm doing well in my work anyway. I think I'll just continue working. And stop studying for a while.
But that's not fair. I think you're overreacting, Mother. You will continue studying. It's not right for you to sacrifice your future for my sake. I won't let you do it. Mother, I won't go to Madame Manning's house anymore. And anyway, my job at Madame Carmen's place will end soon, so it will be easier for me to avoid Cardine.
You have a point.
And I heard Cardine is also leaving for the city soon. A few more days and we'll see the end of him.
Fine, fine. I won't resign from my job anymore.
Yahoo!
Why are you so happy?
Of course, because Mother still has her job. Mother, could you spare me 100? I need to buy some school supplies.
100? Here, I'll give you 50 instead of 100. Use it for whatever you want, but I'm buying the supplies you need. I know where to get them cheap.
All that for 50 pesos?
Okay, Mother. We can talk about it now.
Come here quick. Hurry. Listen, kids. It's almost your sister's birthday. She's turning 18 in 2 days.
Your father and I thought of giving your sister a surprise party.
Nothing lavish. It's just going to be us and Celine.
Mother, could we also invite Diego and Jojo? I owe Diego a lot. He recommended me to work in the factory.
I don't mind. So what do you think, kids?
I'm all for it, Nene.
It's okay, Mother.
This is going to be a surprise, so don't tell her anything, okay?
It's a secret, Pepping, so don't
tell her. Let's go.
Okay,
she might come out soon.
Guess who?
Cardine. Mimi might see you here.
It's okay. She doesn't know I'm here. And anyway, she's with Chelsea and Wendy. So she'll be preoccupied for a while. It's safe for us to talk.
I have a strong feeling something's going on between those two. But they keep on denying it.
Obviously, Luisa wouldn't dare confide in you. But Cardine?
I think Luisa heard our conversation last time. And she told Cardine everything.
The day after tomorrow is your birthday.
You still remember?
Of course I do. So, what gift do you want?
Wendy, that's disgusting!
But I can't help it, I'm hungry. Do you have some food in your bag? Could I have it?
Fool! I don't store food inside my bag.
So what?
What do you want? Tisha!
You know what?
Tisha!
You don't need to call her. Let's just go to your kitchen and see what goodies you have inside your refrigerator. Let's go. What are you waiting for? Come on.
Come on, tell me what you want for your birthday. I'll buy it for you.
Your love is more than enough to make me happy. I want nothing else in this world.
You are my precious love, the only woman for me. Luisa.
Wendy, you eat like a pig. Soon you'll look like one.
You should watch what you eat.
Speak for yourself. You may be sexier and prettier than me, but you still don't have a boyfriend, right?
Shut up!
Hey, that's enough. That is not a nice thing to say. She's upset as it is, so stop annoying her. Leave her alone, Wendy.
It's your fault. Why do you let Cardine and Luisa upset you?
You know what? I think they have a relationship, but they keep denying it. I hate Luisa. She gets on my nerves. And she influences Cardine in the wrong way. So I'm having a hard time manipulating him now.
Can't you do anything about it?
Presently, I can't do anything yet. But I'll soon be on top of things. You can be sure of that. Watch and learn, girls. Watch how I manipulate Luisa and Cardine.
That's right. I'm confident you can do it. You just have to gain control.
Oh, wait, Mimi. Can you ask Tisha to bring us juice?
You shouldn't have stopped me.
Even if you confronted her, nothing good will come out of it. Mimi knows too much about us, Cardine. If she tells my mother and your mother about us, it will cause an uproar.
I thought Mimi was my friend. I didn't know all this time. She was just manipulating me.
That is why Mimi mustn't know anything about our relationship. We shouldn't trust her, Cardine.
Totoy, could you give me some money, please? Because I want to buy a gift for Luisa on her birthday. I'm willing to work and clean all your shoes to pay you back.
You don't need to do that. I think I have some money in my pocket. Here. Here you go, Pipping.
Hi.
Jojo, why'd you tie your hair up? Just let it hang loose.
I had to. It's hot. Well, what do you think, Pipping?
I think you will always look beautiful, no matter how you tie your hair.
Oh, you're so nice. So I don't look like a boy? Be honest.
Well, you don't exactly look like a boy. I don't know.
But why did you say I look like a boy? Who told you that, then?
I can't tell. My brother will get mad.
But why would he get mad at you? Did he tell you not to say the truth? I will ask you one more time, Fipping. Did your brother say I look like a boy?
Let me answer that question. Pipping, why don't you go home and I'll follow you later, okay? Goodbye. Jojo, truth of the matter is, I did tell Pipping that you are somewhat like a tomboy, but...
Pipping, why are you out here?
I'm waiting for Tatoy.
Tatoy? What happened to your face?
This is nothing. I bumped into something.
Bumped into what?
I think I have to get ready. I don't want to be late for work.
Pipping, what happened to your brother?
Why are you asking questions I can't answer? I'm just a little kid. I don't have answers to all those questions.
Like what I said, girls. Soon I will be able to control and manipulate Carding and Luisa.
You're saying Luisa still works here?
Mm-hmm. So I wouldn't have a hard time. I would know every move she makes. And if I have to, I can stop her from going out and having fun. That way, she'll have a hard time attracting Carding's attention. Am I right?
Right.
See?
I am impressed.
Come in.
I'm going home now. And also, I'm not coming back tomorrow.
What? Why?
I paid my debt to you, Mimi.
Don't you want to continue working? You can earn extra money for your family.
No, thank you. I'm fine. Goodbye. I'll go ahead now.
Mimi, tell us again how you can control and manipulate them.
Oh, the nerve.
I can't believe that guy. What a liar. I should beat him up.
Look, Luisa, the sun has set. When it rises again tomorrow, it's going to be your birthday. Are you having a party?
No, it's not like we have money.
So can we meet here again tomorrow?
I'll try if I can go out tomorrow.
Tell them you still have work to do at Mimi's house so that you can go out and be able to meet me here. What is it? What's wrong?
Ever since we've been together, we've been lying to people close to us. This isn't right anymore.
Well, it's not our fault, Luisa. They can't see it our way. If they would only have allowed us to be together, we won't be going around lying and fooling everyone. If you can't bear the lies anymore, I'm willing to face your parents. Let's tell them the truth.
Carding,
I think they'll probably understand our love for each other.
We can't. We can't tell my mother. She might do something irrational.
Well then, let's keep it this way for a while. I can endure anything for you. So, am I seeing you tomorrow? Luisa, this is the first time we're going to be together on your birthday. I'd like to be with you on that day. I want it to be a very special day for both of us. Please? Please, please, please.
Okay, okay. I'll see you tomorrow.
Can you give me a smile? I thought you didn't want to see me anymore. Thank you, my love.